after being assured the prior week that on this Monday, big time Xbox news would be dropping, being on the heels of that apparently not happening. Was this all a farce? And if so, what does this mean for the community? Let's get into it. What's up, people? What's up, people? What's up, people? It is your boy, MM2K, back once again with this episode of The Medicine. Do me a huge favor before we get into this one. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Rock those bells for notifications, please, so you know when your boy's dropping these doses. I appreciate all of y'all straight up. Y'all know the deal. Y'all know the reason. And y'all know the slogan. I am not too proud to ask. Let's get into it. Okay, so we're all familiar with the background here of Xbox. Xbox has no games, right? And that's a moniker. Of course, they got games, but they got games that nobody want when it comes to exclusive software and titles, right? And on the heels of the Xbox Series X being released first at the Video Game Awards, and then that excitement that drew up kind of fizzled a little bit, and then Xbox then dropping specs, and then PlayStation 5 trying to counter it with their specs and it not working out well for PlayStation 5, and now Xbox seems to be running with this momentum. You have other competitors like Amazon and Google Stadia trying to steal some of that thunder. So in response, you got PlayStation 5 dropping this news on its controller, for crying out loud, and that sucked the oxygen out of the room. So you immediately have this news popping up, not only from the Xbox community ethos, but from a well-known source, a well-known entity within the gaming community, IGN, stating that to expect some exciting Xbox news come Monday, which is the day that I'm recording this, right? April 13th 2020. And on the heels of that, you now see people backtracking. Now you see people say, well, don't expect any hardcore news. You've even had IGN say, well, you know what? Don't expect anything big today. And then we get dropped with some Halo audio news for Halo Infinite, right? So, It brings me back. I know I'm stumbling with this, but I'm trying to figure out an effective but nice way to say this, because sometimes I come off a little too jagged to a lot of the more sensitive Xbox community members, and nothing soaks in. But it's the same stuff over and over again. I feel like I'm playing 50 first dates here. So let me say it like this. Excuse me. Xbox community, you guys seem to be doing more harm than good, okay? You really do. I think it would do a lot better for your efforts, because I get it. Y'all want to see Xbox reign dominant again. And to me, there's nothing wrong with that, because you like Xbox, and in order to cement its sustainability, you want it to have as much saturation as possible, if not be number one. Because if it's number one, or if it gets a lot of saturation, that's the more likelihood that you're going to continue to get the stuff that you like. Nothing wrong with that. That's all sensible. But what you got to understand is that when you're coming from behind, and that is your goal, then you can't think things the way that you think are okay, because they already got you. Okay, if you're in the minority, you got to think outside of the box and think about what's going to get those people that left. You can't think about the things that you like, because if you think about the things that you like, then you're not going to grow. And this is a clear example of that continuing to happen in the community. And that's why y'all take a lot of my words outside of my trolling on Twitter, but y'all take a lot of my words as just mean hearsay and all this other stuff. But again, we keep going, running into the same wall over and over and over again. Here's why I say the Xbox community does more harm than good. First and foremost, these insiders keep connecting dots that don't exist, and they create hype not even started from Xbox. And when it comes to fruition that it's vaporware, you know what I'm saying, or people were overreaching, Xbox tends to lose out. This happened last year what E3. See, I'm a steward of history. Maybe that's what it is. You guys just live in the 5 minutes of now. I'm a steward of history. I always like to see how people made mistakes in the past so I don't make those same mistakes in the present. And y'all just live in the first 5 minutes of the internet. You know what I'm saying? This happened last year, where people were hyping up E3 2019, and it ended up being a bad one, but had people not been hyping it up, it wouldn't have had the sustained effect that it did, where you had so many defectors and so many people in disbelief of the Xbox ecosystem. You wouldn't have had that if people weren't hyping it up, okay? And I know, because I fell a victim to the hype train, right? And now you got this again. Look, the Xbox community, this is what they did. They took a quote said on an IGN Xbox podcast, connected it to something that a supposed insider said on Reset Era, and said there's definitely something coming on Monday. And they started blasting it. You know what I'm saying? And y'all got to stop that, because the Xbox community, well, there's two things you got to stop. Number one, you got to stop connecting these dots and trying to make up things that you wish would happen. Because when it doesn't happen, it does more harm than good. And Xbox community, you got to stop listening to these bozos. Just stop it, okay? So that's first and foremost. Secondly, why I say the Xbox community does more harm than good is they keep you focused on bibblewatts and compute units when people are just looking for the best way to play the best games, okay? Now, that's a little bit of opposite of what happened here as far as people seeing good games and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? As far as that being the rumor that was supposed to happen this Monday. But this is the overarching problem with the community. The community thinks it has sustained hype because of bibblewatts and compute units. And then when Sony does something as trivial as drops a controller or releases a logo and they suck all the oxygen out of the room, or Amazon does something as silly as mentioned Project Tempo, or Stadia does something that people feel like they should have done at launch, which is release base, and all that oxygen gets sucked out of the room, that's a signal that people don't have sustained faith that you're going to be able to give them the core of what they need. So it's more evidence. Stop saying, well, Sony didn't do this. Sony already has the trust of the community, whether you think it's right or not. They already have their trust. You have to regain the trust. So because they're showing compute units and bibblewatts and you're getting all excited, that doesn't mean that it's going to sustain the trust of the community. They may get excited temporarily, but again, something as trivial, and I'll be the first one to say it, something as trivial as when a controller drops, that sucks all the oxygen out of the room. So understand, Xbox community, these are not mean words. This is just looking past the first 5 minutes of now and being a steward of history. Y'all got to get out of this bibblewatt, gigahertz talk. Stop saying, well, Sony already got the trust of the community again, right or wrong. You don't. So what the community is best served doing is, number one, stop listening to these fake insiders. If it doesn't come from Xbox, it doesn't exist. Period. If it doesn't come from Xbox, it doesn't exist. Okay? Secondly, get on Xbox's rear end and tell them they need to show the games. I don't care what normally happens in the summertime, because E3 is not here. You are working from behind. If you got good games in the pocket, start showing a third of them at least, and then you can show the rest later. But you got to start maintaining that trust, okay? You got to do it, and it has to resonate and marinate in the mind. That's how mindshare works. You don't just go boom and then all of a sudden it just disappears like a cloud of fog. No, mindshare is something that's worked on over time and has to marinate. You know what I'm saying? It has to age like fine wine. So why not drop a third of what you got now that you were going to surprise people with? Curtail it, wrap it up in a nice pretty bow. Show the other two thirds later when you plan to do it. But again, you got to start working on it now, because again, I sound like a broken record. Mindshare has to marinate. And Xbox community, if you guys stop thinking outside of the first five minutes, stop thinking that all types of criticism is bad and y'all look at everything from 5,000 feet, then y'all got this. You know what I'm saying? You got it. But it's just these simple things that keep holding you back. You know what I'm saying? And it's going to keep holding you back as long as y'all keep playing 51st dates, period. And that's it from your boy MM2K. Hey, let me know what you think about what I had to say in the comment section below, because like I always say, who cares what I think? But if you did like what I have to say, then check out the links below to follow me. Those links will lead you to the Broadband Bullies, PNTS Network, Hard Knock Digital Culture, and yes, the Stadia Dosage. And with that said, you all have a wonderful, wonderful gaming day. Peace.